Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, Artificial Intelligence, Machine Learning, Big Data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then do please do write me at contact@devopsschool.com.
Right, so what I've done is I've created a virtual service and I have created the ingress gateway. So I've created a gateway, but I haven't created the virtual service. So let me create this virtual service, which is associated with the HTTP gateway. So I'm going to do a kubectl apply on the virtual service. So our virtual service is up and running. I mean, we have successfully created it. We have now all the artifacts which were required for our services to expose outside the cluster. So let's see if now we are able to access the service. Now, how we are going to access the service, let's see. In the virtual service, we had defined that. So what this virtual service is saying, if we are getting a traffic with host entry as this, and it is coming from this gateway, then match whether the URI is this. If URI is this, then send to this destination. So this is the meaning of this configuration. I'll just iterate it for better understanding. This virtual service says that any traffic which is coming for this host and from this gateway, I want those requests, and in those requests I will verify whether this is the URI which is coming, the prefix of URI, as in URI should start from this. I don't care what is after this, but if the URI is starting from this, then route it to this destination. So destination is where we give the actual Kubernetes service.
Sorry? So virtual service acting as a reverse proxy, URI redirection.
Correct. Virtual service is actually the reverse proxy. And even your ingress gateway is the reverse proxy. So we will see it further and it will be more clear to you guys how exactly the traffic is flowing. There is something called a Kali dashboard, which will give you the picture of what exactly is happening in your service mesh. We will see all this. Just give me 5-10 more minutes and we'll see all these. So I have successfully created a virtual service now. Now, how do we access it? Now, we know that this deops.school.istio.demo, we will not be able to access it through our normal browser because the DNS will not find the IP address for this, right? So it doesn't know what it is, right? So what we have to do is we have to associate this with an IP address. And since we are running a single node cluster, we will need the node's IP here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do kubectl describe nodes and I'm going to grep it with IP. So since this is a minikube, we have only internal IP. When you're running in cloud, there will be a separate internal IP and external IP, and we have to use external IP in that case. So this is the IP address which I have to use. So what I'll do is I will update my host entry in my local so that this IP address is associated with the host name which I have just given here. So for that, what you will have to do is you will have to edit your host entry. So I'm going to do etc hosts. So for this one, my IP address would be 1.68.39.56. Okay, I've closed this. And now my this host name, which I wrote in URL in the browser, now at least the IP address will be found for this because I've made a host entry. So next thing is the port number. What happens is when you're using a single node cluster, your node ports, your actual node's port number will be used rather than the load balancer. So if we were using a, the multi-node cluster, which is having a proper gateway and all, we could have used the same port which we are giving in our configuration, which is port 80, and it should have worked. But since we are directly accessing the node, we will have to give the node port. So what is the port number of the node? That we will find using our services. So let me just do a kubectl get services hyphen n istio system. So this is going to display all the services which are running in istio system. Let's see which are the services. So as we know, there's an egress gateway, there is an ingress gateway, and an istio d. So these were the three pods also, and these are the three services also. In the istio ingress gateway, in the ports, we are seeing that port 80 is actually mapped to 30076. So instead of using port 80, we will have to use port number 30076. So this mapping we can find from kubectl get svc on istio system. So now I know that I have to use port number as this one. Now next thing is the URI. What was the URI which we configured in our code? So it was v1/istio demo. So let's see if we are able to access it now. So it will be v1/istio demo. Yeah. So see, I got a successful response from my service, which means that the traffic went from the Istio ingress gateway to the virtual service, then to the Kubernetes service, and then to the pod.
Okay. Can you go to that screen putty session?
This one? Code. Oh, this one.
No.
Yeah.
Code. So here we are using this load balancer, right? So we should not expose this IP.
Hey viewers, our Master in DevOps Engineering program can help you to hone the skills necessary to succeed in high-level DevOps positions. So what are you waiting for? Enroll now and earn certification that show you are keeping pace with today's technical roles and requirements. Contact info is mentioned in the video sidebars and in the description box. Book your seats for the upcoming batches now.
10.102.186.48, or we have to expose only the node IP. What's the difference? No,
this is the cluster IP. So it is visible only within the cluster. It is not visible to outside the cluster.
Okay. If we are going with the AWS cloud or GCP, then we have to use this, we have to expose this IP, right?
No, when you are going with cloud and when you run this kubectl get svc hyphen and istio system, here you will get an external IP, which is pending right now, right?
Okay.
So here you will find that an external IP is listed here. So that you have to use for IP address.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
Okay.
And then you will be able to use this port directly because you're not using the actual nodes port, you're using the port which you have exposed.
Yeah, got it.
Okay, so what we have done now is, where is the diagram? So from the ingress gateway, it went to virtual service, then it went here, and from here, it went to the pod. So this was the plain HTTP traffic.
Yeah, one more query. So here we are not using ingress gateway of kube system. We are using
nowhere.
Okay. So we are it's a very direct straightforward request. we are using gateway of the specific service, Istio service, and the virtual service, and we are reaching to the respective pods.
Exactly. So whenever you are creating a gateway, gateway as runs on the edge proxy, as I said earlier. So whenever you are creating a gateway, you have to associate with a virtual service, and virtual service is going to get configured that where it has to route this traffic.
So how the architecture will be there if I'm using AWS load balancer and the Istio system ingress gateway, Nitin?
So we are using the Istio system ingress gateway only, and when you are using AWS, IBM Cloud, Azure, anything, this remains the same. Only thing which is going to change is, above this, there will be an external load balancer, which is provided by your cloud. External load balancer like Cloudflare and all you will have, right? So this external load balancer, so first the request will come here, and actually in the ingress gateway, the IP address which will be populated here, it will be your load balancers, external load balancers IP.
So, okay.
It will automatically use that external load balancer.
This was our actual doubt here. So, can you go to that code, Visual Studio Code?
Yeah.
Can you run kubectl get gateways, the virtual service specific to default namespace?
Yeah.
So first you explained about the ingress gateway, and the ingress gateway which resides first Istio ingress gateway load balancer. From there, the request is coming to virtual service, and the virtual service, the request is going to the SVC. From both this gateway and
from load balancer to ingress gateway, I guess, Arun.
Yeah, from load balancer to ingress gateway.
So in our case, there is no load balancer. That's what I'm saying. There is no external load balancer. We are running Minikube, so we don't have a physical load balancer sitting before our cluster. So this is external to cluster. The word I'm using external because it is not part of cluster. So this is where your cluster is.
I'm clear with the virtual space.
I'll send it to back. Okay. So this external load balancer is external to your cluster.
No, this
it is given
this,
to your cloud.
Yeah. Got it, Nitin. My question is, I'm clear with the virtual service. It's acting as a reverse proxy, and based on the URI mapping, it's routing the request to the respective services. That's clear.
Yeah.
But here we could see two gateways, right? One is on the ingress, Istio ingress gateway. Another one is a gateway service.
No. Okay, see, this HTTP gateway is nothing but a ingress gateway only. So this is only we have created it in this namespace, but as I said, it gets executed. Okay, let me show one thing.
You got it right. You got my question.
Let me just show you what happens actually.
Okay.
I'm going to just list all the pods in my Istio system. Okay. This is my ingress gateway pod name. What I'm going to show you guys is kubectl. So I'm going to follow the logs for this. Okay, sorry. Not from why?
Kube system.
Okay, sorry.
Sorry, Istio system.
Okay, now let me hit a request. Okay, now remember we had created only a gateway named this one, right? But there is no pod with this name. Okay, there is no physical pod which is actually listening to this gateway service. This actually runs within this ingress gateway. As you can see, the request which we hit went inside the ingress gateway pod of Istio system. So actual physical request is being listened by the pod in the Istio system namespace only. Here we are only creating namespaced things so that, so for example, if I had given here in my virtual service, where is my virtual service? This is my virtual service. So for example, if I had created it in a different namespace than default, what would have happened is it wouldn't have found this destination itself, because it will only look for this name within the same namespace and it will not be able to find it, and it will give you a 404 not found. If you have to communicate from one namespace to another, that is possible, but you will have to give the full name.
Hey viewers, trying to get into DevSecOps? Enroll for our DevSecOps certified professional programs and earn the certification that shows you are fit for these technical roles and requirements. Contact info is mentioned in the video sidebars and in the description box. Book your seats for the upcoming batches now.
Full name means Istio demo v1 dot cluster dot default dot your namespace dot cluster dot local. That complete name you have to give, only then it will be able to do. So that's why namespaced things work, that it will look only within that namespace. Otherwise, it gets physically executed on the ingress gateway only, the physical pod which is running in the Istio system. And that's where this point also comes in, that when we are running edge proxy, in the diagram I've showed here a single gateway. So here you are creating multiple configurations for different namespaces, but everything is going here. So let me write here explicitly, this is with Istio system.
That's the thing. You can give us some color codes. What are all the Istio components over there in this thing, and what is the Kubernetes component? You can differentiate something.
These two are Istio component.
You can give some color for the two for getting better understanding for the box.
Sure. Fill is there.
At least the text can be highlighted to some color.
I got it. This is a virtual service, this is a gateway. But all the colorful stuffs are Istio, all the non-colorful stuffs are your
Kubernetes, right?
Kubernetes, yes.
Okay.
Okay, shall we move forward? So, yes, one more thing we can do quickly. As I mentioned, now the dashboards are not coming up along with the Istio, so you're not able to see them, but using the demo profile, the Istio CTL, you will be able to install them. So let me just show you how that is done. So I'll go to samples. So Kiali is a dashboard with which you can visualize your mesh and you will be able to see how the traffic is flowing. So this is an added advantage of using Istio. The visualization is given. Which is given is excellent. Kubectl apply-f. I'm going to create Prometheus and Kiali for now. I'm not going to install Grafana and Jaeger or things like that right now. So we'll have to wait a few minutes before it comes up. So it is still container creating. Okay, so meanwhile, we'll proceed further. We'll wait for that to come up. So next thing we have to do is, now we have exposed the service as a plain HTTP, but of course we cannot really expose our production services on plain HTTP. So let's see how easy it is to expose the same service on TLS. And in fact, we will also see how we can do a mutual TLS. So that we are going to explore. And before that, actually, let's do some simpler stuff first. So the virtual service is where we do all the routing. So most of the routing stuff happens in the virtual service. There are a lot of things which can be done. And a few of them, we will just see how we can do it. So the first thing which we will see is traffic mirroring. So traffic mirroring is a capability which is given by Istio. Again, to the question earlier, whether why we are using Istio, why we are not using ingress of this Kubernetes, because you won't get this feature. So in this feature, what Istio is giving you is it will mirror your traffic to a different service. What happens is you might have a use case. So for example, you want a new release to go in production, but first you would want that release to be tested against the production data. So what you can do is, these are called as dark releases. There's a specific word called dark releases. What happens is you deploy this new service, this new version v1.1, and you don't basically make it your primary version, but what you do is you use the mirror configuration, and in that you give the destination as this v1.1. So what will happen is all the traffic which is coming to this particular service will also be mirrored to this. And mirroring happens out of band. What that means is, it doesn't matter whether this service is failing or passing or there's a delay or whatever, it doesn't impact this main service at all. It happens out of band. It doesn't have any latency impacts also. So without impacting your production, you're testing your new version against production data. So this is one of the use cases of mirroring, but there are a lot of other use cases. You can do a mirroring for any troubleshooting issues, if you want a dump of your database, or if you just want to have a dump somewhere else for all the messages which are coming to a particular service, things like this. If you want to do mirroring, is the solution for that. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to apply this. Okay, and even before that, so I cannot apply this particular thing for now. And the reason being, okay, I can still apply it, but still I'll tell you what we are missing right now. So let's see what are the pods running in our default namespace. Oh, sorry. So these are the pods running, but you can see they're running with single container, as in the only container which is there is the main container. There is no sidecar which is running. So we have still not injected our sidecar. So we need to first inject our sidecar so that these pods are running along with the Istio proxy. So currently there is no Istio proxy in these pods. So how we can do that? I have the command here.
Hey viewers, are you looking for formal training on SRE practices? Take our SRE program. This course will teach you how to successfully implement site reliability engineering in the modern day 24/7 services. Kickstart your SRE training today. Contact info is mentioned in the video sidebars and in the description box. Book your seats for the upcoming batches now.
There are multiple ways of doing it. You can have, so Istio CTL can help you generate a YAML file which will have this injection enabled, or you can inject the whole namespace, a particular namespace, so that everything that is deployed there by default will have Istio injection enabled. So this is what mostly we do in production, so that we don't allow anything which is out of your service mesh, which you will not even know what is running, right? So that's where, so this is the command which I will use. Let me show you. So, so default namespace has been labeled, but when you are labeling a namespace, you will have to redeploy your stuff or you will have to recreate your pod. So the so all the new deployments now will have the Istio injection enabled, but whatever is existing, you either have to redeploy or you have to restart. So for now, I'm going to restart our pods. Come on, it's taking some time. Let me see if my, okay, at least our Kiali and Prometheus are running. So now we'll jump onto that once so that we don't waste any time. So you just use Istio CTL dashboard Kiali. That's all. It will launch your Kiali dashboard. So as I mentioned earlier, Kiali dashboard will help you visualize your service mesh. So it will give us a single graph of everything, a single view of your whole mesh. So currently the graph will be empty, I think, because there has been no traffic, and it just sees through all the traffic which is going through. And using that itself, it will be able to create this graph from where the traffic is going to where. Okay. Everything is a bit slow. Let me close a few stuff. Now you see there will be two containers which will come up since we have restarted it. So it will have Istio proxy as well along with the main container. I'll just delete the other pod as well. The system is dying.
So this clearly,
what can
here we need this envoy proxy sidecar is required, right, for this clearly dashboard?
No, it will still show you the traffic which is coming in the ingress gateway and the virtual service. Okay. It will still show you that, and it will show you the Kubernetes service as well. So even without the sidecar, it will still show.
Okay. The sidecar.
The thing is that I'm running out of memory. I'll probably need a restart of the system, only then it will be nice.
Sidecar, Nathan, the sidecar injection is also your proxy, right?
When you are doing a sidecar injection, in that you are saying that every deployment should automatically have the sidecar enabled, as in it should pop up the Istio proxy along with the main container. You are telling Kubernetes that.
Yeah, that's fine. The use of the sidecar is it's also doing a proxy kind of thing, right? It is also
correct. It is the proxy. So everything in and out of your actual container will go via the Istio proxy.
That means this sidecar proxy is only used for the internal communication between the pods.
This sidecar proxy is for internal, yes, kind of. But see, there are a lot of other policies. It's not just about traffic routing. For example, the next session, maybe we will look at, say, JWT validation. So when you do a JWT validation using an authorization policy, you apply that authorization policy to a particular pod, for example, for a workload. So that will be executed by the sidecar proxy only.
Can you come again, Nitin?
Okay, I'm giving you an example. Suppose in the next session, when we are covering, say, JWT validation, which is a feature given by Istio, you can have JWT validation using something called an authorization policy. So that authorization policy you apply to pods, okay, to workloads.
Thanks for watching. Want to study further? Join our training programs today.